to me, this is the true way science should be taught. And really, this is the way we would like to see all of our classrooms become.
It is what science, what I envision science always should be.
We've always integrated some sort of lab or activity or hands-on activity, but we never had that connection of that the puzzle pieces connecting is what we said.
It makes more sense that, okay, we're doing this activity because it helps us figure out something, not just we're doing an activity to do an activity.
The culture in the classroom is the students are leading where they're going to go next.
We're used to just giving information and feeling like they're never going to get it if we don't give it to them. And so that was a lot for me to give up that role as a teacher.
It's really hard for me to not like give them an answer. Like they'll ask me a question and sometimes I can't give them the direct answer because they need to figure it out.
And it took some adjustment for our teachers because our teachers were so used to delivering content and they were the holders of the content and they had to train themselves to step back.
One of the specific examples where I saw the kids debating and having some discourse was an observation that I was able to do in one of our seventh grade science classrooms. And they were in the scientific circle.
Where you do it on your own, you talk as a group, then you come to the scientist circle.
So they're all sitting around and they're really brainstorming as to what's happening.
It really surprised me how invested my kids got into the storyline, because we did the metabolic reactions one with McKenna, mm-hmm. and all they wanted to talk about was McKenna, what's wrong with McKenna? And it lasted, there were a few kids, it lasted the whole entire time. They were so curious and they just wanted to know about it.
My favorite part was in the beginning when we had to guess all the things that was going on with McKenna.
And, some kids would agree with the person that just spoke. Some kids were adamantly against it.
And then throughout the lesson, we had to keep on going and narrow it down by the different pieces of evidence that we had to put together and find out what was actually wrong with McKenna.
It was a really good, almost adult-like discussion.
When they don't agree with someone, they back it up with evidence now. It's not just, hey, I don't agree with you, I don't think you're right. It's like, hey, you're not right, or I disagree with you because of this, this, and this.
I really liked being able to debate what we thought was wrong with her. And, we could each say, what we thought it was, and then maybe someone else who didn't usually speak would, pipe up to say, why that's wrong, maybe.
And I feel like some of the kids that we don't normally hear from, we're hearing from. Because they feel more comfortable. They feel like my opinion has value.
I think listening to everybody's opinion, hearing what other people have to say, because it might change your mind, and if you're trying to give up and you hear some good stuff that other people are saying and they back it up really well.
They can figure those things out if you let them.
Even those kids who don't feel like they could say something in scientist circle for whatever reason, we still have an opportunity to see what they think, individually and in a group setting. So it gives us as teachers multiple ways to see where our kids are.
I'm really excited about what I see. Our teachers are really excited. Our administrative team is really excited.
They're thinking way higher than I've ever seen before, and that's very powerful.
We all express our ideas, and we have a big debate, pretty much.
They're having fun with it, and that's important. When the students are engaged, they're having fun, they're learning. So that's been the most interesting piece for me. It really makes it feel like this is true science.